This is Animation Nights New York, Animator Interviews. Thank you so much to Animation for Adults for letting us be a part of their channel. My name is Nina Balton, and next up in our series is an interview with Qieer Wang. Qieer is an independent animation filmmaker, freelance illustrator, comic artist, designer, and part-time tattoo artist. Animation Nights New York officially selected her film, Therapy Room, to be featured in a to-be-determined upcoming screening event. We sat down to talk at 180 Maiden Lane in a nice and quiet side room, where we were able to have an intimate conversation. Please enjoy.
Well, thank you so much for coming today.
Yeah.
I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
So I've just become recently familiar with your work, and I have to say that like you have so many things going on. You like to put your hands in a lot of different places.
Exactly.
So I guess the thing that I was first most curious about is your process, because I've noticed with your films you tend to have a concrete idea of what you're trying to capture. So do you normally start with your ideas first and then work with how you depict it, or do you is it more like a subconscious free flow and then later like you assign it meaning? Like, how do you normally go about your process?
So basically I have like two hands on two type of work. Like for commission work with like my clients, we need to have some like sketches and what's going on in and about this time and what's going on that time. But for my own project, I'm more like what you just said, like subconsciously following the flow. Because I really like, for example, I actually do like a sort of commission, but also like my own project with my friend, Lane, and she has a band, like a hardcore, like experimental music piece. I was actually working on that today, like right before I come here.
Oh,
I was
wow.
like so like exhausted. The deadline is tomorrow.
Oh wow. Oh my gosh.
Yeah,
well,
yeah.
Good luck with that.
I know, I have to do it. Like, where did I say? Like, let me just go away.
Oh, you're talking about your process.
So it's sort of like a mission and also my personal work. So at the first part, I'm just following what the lyrics and the how the music make me feel. Like, instant, I have some visual, I just pull it out.
Right.
And they like it. So it works. Like, for different clients, it has different sort of like approach. Yeah.
So when did you start animating?
Officially, I think it's my 2015.
Oh wow!
Yeah, it's because we have like I come to US in 2014 for my grad school, and we have like so many different kind of like weird and whatever exploration workshops. So I went to this workshop about stop motion. Just fall in love with it. Like, animation is so good, and just keep doing it until now.
So is your background in illustration beforehand?
Yeah, like game illustration, which is far away from this.
like concept art?
Yeah, concept art.
Oh really?
Yeah.
And where did you go to undergrad?
Undergrad in my city in China.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
It's in the south, my city, Chengdu. I know you know.
So let's see. So your film, Therapy Room, has been selected for our screening event. We haven't yet decided a date yet, but it is in consideration. It's very lovely. I've watched it a few times.
Thank you.
And when I've looked through your different works, your gift sets, even your tattoo art, which you do now, which is really cool. There does seem to be a reoccurring theme where you like to explore mental illness or mental disorders and like depicting them visually. Is there a particular reason why you keep coming back to that subject again and again?
Because I feel it's weird and interesting. Like, mental stuff is more like interior of a human being, right? And it's all about emotions. And art, for me, is all about emotions. So they come into the same channel, in the end, mm-hmm. in my mind. So just part of my interpretation about art, like sort of heal people, or like you in a way, or you annoy people in a way, things like that. Yeah.
Okay. Because I just found it fascinating, because I saw you revisit it multiple times, and trying to depict it visually for perhaps people who aren't aware of how it is to experience it. And I think I remember you reading that you talked to some people in order to get an idea.
Yeah. I actually do interview with the professor, professional in this field. So I did interview with her, and about what is the background, like how scientific can this field be? Like, they give me so many ideas about categories and how, like, there's like basically four approaches to those mental illness. But actually, after like a year and a half, like exploring this project, I feel like categorize, it's bullshit. So like for now, I want to, like, let's just get rid of the categories, because how can we categorize emotion in like different blanket, because they're all together, they're like water and liquids and flows. You cannot say, okay, this has come from where, like a scientific, like, you know, saying. I don't think it can like interpret it.
So you don't entirely. Like the biological aspect of
psychology?
Yeah,
because I explore it for a long time, mm-hmm. and finally I find out it doesn't make sense. Mm-hmm. Like I don't know if you're familiar with this alliance and national. Like NAMI?
No.
That's a, like a community in the US, like a mental health group, like community. So they basically give those patients or like audience like a way to understand what is mental illness, and they give like definitions about each, like anxiety, depression, and manic, and blah blah blah.
Yeah, each diagnosis.
Yeah. So actually, I start with those category, and I read it, and I talk with people, or like I watch online, and I try to approach it in a visual way, but just after so many things I've done. Mm-hmm. I feel it doesn't make sense right now. Yeah.
No, that's really interesting.
Yeah, it's like a way, like I'm learning. And finally, after I learn about those shit, I suddenly find it doesn't make sense. So
That people, the categories?
The categories. Yeah.
Not people's experiences.
Yeah, experience, that definitely makes sense, because it's experience. So. Yeah, I just want to approach it in a more like interactive way of my visual art later. And also, I have this honor to collaborate with this professor, and we will have a show in the psychiatric hospital in Johns Hopkins like two months from now.
Oh wow!
Yeah. And I'm really excited about like showing those pieces to real like patients, like see how they feel, and they will give us like survey and back feedbacks.
About,
so I can yeah about that, this project.
That's so wonderful.
Yeah.
Like how did so you said you started in 2014,
mm-hmm.
and yet you already have so many people wanting you and wanting your work. Like how did you establish yourself? How did you what were you doing that like just had all these opportunities come to you? Was it just being connections in school or?
I don't know. I just like just do works every day. Like I'm just doing what I want to do, and maybe someday, like, someone find me, they want to do the same thing. Like, we found each other for some, I don't know, like, same kind of person. And then we do work together. Yeah.
So how long have you been making art? Has it been since childhood? And were you encouraged when you were young by your family? Or did anyone ever draw with you or make art with you and, like, help foster that love of creating?
Mm-hmm. I did do drawing stuff, like ink drawing, like Chinese brush ink when I was in kindergarten school, like, for fun. But actually afterwards I quit.
Mm.
I'm actually, like, I do ballet and, like, dancing for, like, 10 years.
Oh, wow.
And also I do, like, piano for 10 years without, I don't know why.
Do you still play?
No, I don't have time, and I don't have a piano right now.
Yeah, but if you had one, would you remember?
Yeah, like, part of it, but I'm not talented, you know? Just, like, find a way to release, like, energy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess so. So I think, like, my family sort of gave me a background of, like, growing sort of artistic feeling, like, release myself in, rather than, like, I don't know, just more, it's not, like, words, it's more abstract. Like dancing and also like piano music.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like, and also my family members, we have some painters in our like ancestor sort of.
Oh, wow.
So I don't know him, but.
Right.
Yeah. I actually saw his painting. It's really like amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Like drawing, maybe. I don't know. It's just beautiful.
So you were always encouraged to express yourself with all these various mediums?
Mm,
or no?
Not really.
Not really?
Yeah, like, yeah, not really.
That does bring up another thing that another pattern I've noticed in some of your work are relationships.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, You tend to depict arguments a little violently, like with the devouring of the face. I've had that one stop motion film, Always.
You mean, that's the very first one.
That was your very first film you made?
Yeah, and I fall in love with the animation because of that.
I mean, it's amazing. Like, it's so...
Oh, thank you.
It was so jarring when he first devoured the person, and I was like, what is he...
Devour people.
And then they regurgitated themselves, and then again in a therapy room, when the character is in the therapy room with the baby that they make, they are like trying to destroy it and like bite their face and things like. So you have a really visceral way of depicting disagreements and like not so smooth relationships.
Yeah. That's how my personality is, sort of. Like, I feel like relationship is a battle.
Mm.
Like, you need to defend yourself in a lot of relationship. Like I see myself like as a soldier.
Really?
Yeah. Like, I also feel like every day in my life right now, in this page of my life, it's battle every day because I have so many things to do.
Right.
I'm like, okay, I wake up and okay, I have this list to do. And I'm just pray for 1 second, I will be the winner and come back home. You know, that's how I feel, like my attitude right now. It's like that.
Mm.
So maybe that also like influenced me about how I see relationships. Yeah.
Okay, mm-hmm. So more on Therapy Room, like how did you begin that film?
How did I begin? Oh, it's a really like lovely story. I have this story about throwing up him or herself when I was in sophomore undergrads. Mm. So I always wanted to do it. And finally, like, I sort of find a way I can pull this out
and
in grad school.
Visualize it.
Yeah. Actually, I didn't make it, like, thoroughly, like, completely the way I think I would do. Mm. I would do another like, stop motion, like, claymation, like, about that.
So you would revisit that subject of vomiting oneself or, like, expelling oneself and
faking. Yeah, sort of, like, releasing oneself. Yeah, in another topic. Yeah.
That's a fascinating concept, because I remember, you know, I was sort of following the abstraction, you know, the character was in an office, their job wasn't very pleasant, and the phone calls are sort of like tore at their soul and, like, weighed them down, and then the credit card mouth, and, like, but then the room itself, it was the toilet, and they, like, took off their skin and just sort of sat there and, like, fought with this mirror of themselves.
I feel like that's how I feel about therapy. Like, even with your friends, like, you sometimes you talk about some bullshit stuff you encounter today. Mm-hmm. Is she or him your toilet right now? Like, she or he is, like, taking it without complaining, like, for good, which is nice. Yeah, and we need to pay for it when you go to, like, strangers, like, professional strangers.
Yeah, of course.
Professional stranger toilet.
Professional stranger toilet. That's what therapists are.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Let's see here. So you have a very distinct style with your work, and you work in a lot of different mediums, and it seems like you like exploring different mediums.
Yeah.
Do you have a how do you decide what medium is best for what idea? Because I've seen that you've done comics, you've done illustration pieces, you've done gift sets, you've done, obviously, films. Like, is that mostly because of commission asking you for a specific thing, or is there a way where you're like, this idea would be best in this form?
I think most of the project you were mentioning about, I finished them when I was in high school. Grad school. Mm-hmm. So I actually have the freedom to do, like, which media I want. So I ask about it, like, I ask myself about it as well, like, why, like, I jumping around this to this and that. But after a while, I feel there's no need to question that, because it's just different formats, just different faces, but with the same soul. So I think if I feel this time I use my arm, okay, you know,
yeah.
Like, you can give the best and the most of your energy to show to the audience or to express this idea the best, you choose that. Mm. Yeah, that's why.
Yeah. And then the visual style, I mean, you have a few, obviously, like, what are some of your influences for those, the way that you draw the body, for instance, and the distortions of the body, and...
Like, the flowing, like...
Yeah, like, what are your artistic influences? Like, what do you draw from when you, I guess, towards the beginning, when you were first starting out as an artist and, like, exploring your voice and your style?
Yeah. I recently, like, while I'm doing some annoying work, I will, like, watch the films I watched, like, long time ago. So I started to recognize that why I have this flowy body in my mind, because I watched so many, like, European cartoons when I was young. I think that's definitely one of my, like, influence. Yeah,
European cartoons, generally, they have more... The movement it's not meant to look like realistic movement, it's more expressionistic.
Yeah, I guess so. And I always, like, attracted to this artist with really strong like language in their visuals. Feel like, I don't know the word is right or provocative. Is that the right word? Yeah. Yeah. Like you feel like it beats you in somehow, like somewhere. Mm. Yeah.
Are there any particular names or?
I'm so bad at names.
It's okay.
I have at least like just visual. I have really good visual memories, but I have really bad like words. Like, and their name is so complicated.
I wouldn't say you're bad with words, because I've in all your various posts, when you talk about your art, you have a really unique way of explaining your what you were trying to accomplish with the piece. Mm. And it's almost like a poem, your descriptions, I feel.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some of my friends, they comment on my way to like name my piece, said, I don't really understand. I would never understand. But it makes sense.
Let's see. So you have a few films. You've had Always, which was your first one.
Mm-hmm.
You had Therapy Room, which is the one that we're featuring. You've had Dystopia Rooms, which is another stop motion one that's also about mental illness. There's Toe Petal Cosmos. What about that one? That one was very different from the other ones that you've made.
That one, it's really chill. Like, just play with your toes forever. I don't know. It's it starts like really just in the cafe with my friends, where we're just feeling so bored. Like, hey, let's do something. Some weird shit. And he said, yeah. And I just, actually, I don't have my tablet at that point. So I just used my finger to draw on my computer and say, hey, what do you think about this character? He said, oh, looks good, let's do it. So I start. Actually, it's based on like a theory I always wanted to like talk about. And I actually is talking about it all the time.
Mm.
The acquaintance theory. I don't know if you're familiar with that.
What theory?
Quantum
theory.
Quantum.
No, it's fine. I don't mean to.
What is that? Yeah, that one. I feel it's really, like, really fit my own philosophy.
Mm.
Like, everything maybe existing in a different format, but they're the same. I don't know, they form into different stuff. But when you take it back, it's just the same. I don't know how to describe it, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, so like everything is made up of the same stuff, and we're all like connected. And
yeah.
And I got that from the film with the flowers and the little toe people. It was very mesmerizing, especially the sound. The sound was very like.
Yeah, we mix a lot of, like we found a piece from Mars. Like from NASA.com something, and found some other vocal, like we mixed them together too. Yeah,
so how do you, so you, this is your friend who has the band that you said and like does a lot of the audio for you?
Oh, later,
is it a different friend?
It's different friends.
Okay.
The toe pedal one, he's in China right now.
Okay.
Yeah. And this girl, I actually met her here. She right now is in Boston, and she's gonna move to New York soon.
Oh, very cool.
Yeah,
so you can collaborate more.
Yeah.
So does she sort of take the lead with the sounds, or do you work really closely with her for the sound design?
I work really close with her, like, but because I saw, like, we're like really. We didn't meet each other after we finished the first collaboration.
Mm-hmm.
The first collaboration is The First Breath, the music video I made.
The one with the monster with
the face.
The many noses.
Yeah, that one. I'm so satisfied with that music piece. After that, I don't know, I just feel this person know me. So I don't need to say too much. She will just do the best. Yeah.
That's so lucky to have found somebody soon.
And she gave me her favorite piece in her new album. That's the one I'm working right now. It's a 9-minute long animation music video.
That's very long.
Yes. But I'm really in love with it. And it's gonna come in May, I think. Yeah.
Oh, I'm looking forward to that. That sounds amazing.
Yeah, and she like gave me 100% like trust. Like I do whatever, and she would just love it. So it's really great. Yeah.
No, definitely. Like your life is, your work is so exciting. Like you have so many amazing projects. Like, so. Since you said you do commission work, how do you go about it differently than your own personal work? Do you enjoy it as much, or is it more challenging?
It's more challenging. You know, it's different from your own work. Like, you're working with someone. You need to compromise about your ideas and they pay you, so you better compromise.
Yeah. Have you ever had any like major compromises you had to make about a piece?
You mean animation or
yeah, anything that you've done. I guess particularly animation, because you did that opening for that documentary film about the Chinese ceremony.
Oh, damn, I'm compromising a lot. Like they still ask me to do like version 4.
That's not even the final version?
No.
Oh my.
I want to cry, but I don't know. I need to do it. Yeah, like you need to compromise the way you handle your elements in your visual language a lot. Yeah.
Like, have you ever like submitted something and they were like, absolutely not, you like have to start over?
Well, what do you mean?
Well, like, have you ever like when you were working on a commission and you gave them your first pass, and do you have any like funny stories of them being like, like this isn't the direction that we were interested in, or like this is a little more...
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Like, just for example, this intro, the first version I gave them, like, oh, is this a sketch? And later, like, the second version. Like, the second version is the one I put online. Mm-hmm. And it said, oh, this is the end? I was like, yeah, this is the end.
They wanted you to do more, like, realistic style?
They want more element and, like, shiny, like fancy, and also they comment on the way I interpreted the Chinese wedding. They think the way I handle this intro is too Western. Western.
Too Western.
Yeah, they need something more Asia. Like, they need the pace to be really slow and smooth and have so many like teeny tiny sparkle, like loving stories. I don't know where should I get it, but I don't know. I feel sort of embarrassed because I'm from China, and I'm Chinese, and I'm Asian, and they just comment on my work is so like not Asian. So I don't know, maybe different generations.
What would make your work more Asian?
I don't know.
Yeah, like that's such a bizarre request.
Yeah, true.
I guess we could talk about First Breath, too. I mean, if you don't mind going to that one.
Sure. What do you want to talk about?
Let's see. So you said it was inspired by mythology?
Yeah. It's Asian.
Is it Chinese?
I forgot it's Chinese or not. Like, this world start with the monster, actually, I think I changed it, sort of, because I don't want to, like, just follow the really original, sort of boring. So, it's actually a woman, she she started to make some muddy kids to play with because she's sort of bored. Mm-hmm. Chinese people, if I say something wrong, ignore me. That's my version. So, yeah, she made some muddy kids to play with, and suddenly she feel, okay, I want to make them alive, and she just point them, and they're alive, and they're like bunch of like naked babies, and they run onto the land, and later they found like they don't have any like living, and they cannot, like there's no habitat, right? And this woman, like, okay, she just point everything, like point river, point land, point grass, point trees and farms, and everything's existing. And while it, like, you know, the end of the world is basically like the water like, flow and everything's gone. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I sort of get like use that end in my end as well.
And why did you want to animate this story?
To be honest, I always like really attracted to Tibetan the religion. They actually have a really traditional art form. Like they use sand, different color of sand to paint, and it's a really large piece. And after they finish it, they just blow them off.
Yeah, I've seen those. They're so amazing.
This like the process is it means everything. Like it doesn't matter like if it can like put them like stick them in the museum and for like 100 years. It doesn't matter. It's just like 1 second like your life is done. Yeah, I feel the first breath is the same idea. Like you just saw the land is coming up from the drop, and then the flow it away, and everything started over again. Yeah, I really like that idea.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Thank you.
Really beautiful.
Oh, talking about that, I think you would like to see this piece because it's sort of like the baby. The
toilet baby.
not the toilet baby, but it's a pretty big like drawing. Yeah, it's like 33 by 24 inches, and just draw like so many people like running into a new world.
Oh wow!
I think maybe this kind of stuff is always subconsciously in my mind somewhere. So that's why.
Like beginnings and endings.
Yeah.
I can see the movement in.
It's a pretty fun.
And the way the people are, like, I can, like, sort of see the wiggling a little, like, it's a still illustration.
Yeah. And I really, like, I want to thank for my animation, actually. I think, the way, like, I do animation, sort of building up my language in a way, because if you just want to tell something, like conceptually tell something, you wouldn't even care about the language you're using, you're just naturally doing. So that natural things is your thing. I feel like that, yeah. It's like influenced me in like both ways.
So you found that animation has helped you communicate concepts better?
Well, it's like practice. Not like better or like just for myself.
Yeah.
Oh, I should have mentioned about my trip to Holland Film Festival.
Oh,
the animation festival. And so my film was selected and become a winner there in the small program.
Which film?
And Title Untitled.
Oh yeah, those were the.
It's a gift that get combined together. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I met some interesting people. And the most interesting thing is the VR animation. I really, really, really want to do it. Yeah, like I have the access to the program already. Like,
oh really?
Yeah, I just need the time to like do it. Like,
what would you do with VR?
Oh, actually, it's a really interesting project. Like, it might be the end of the mental health project for like a short time. Mm-hmm. So it's gonna be an interactive piece. Like, in this VR environment, I may have like two or three different people. Like, they just sit there or they stand there, like animated, and they when you go into it, mm-hmm. you talk to them. Like, you choose one to talk to, and you can really talk with him because he or she might like a Siri. Like, you can just talk to him, and you can, like, what, maybe they will hug you or they touch you. You will really feel it, because I want to design the sensing design as well. Mm. Like, as the guy from Denmark, he said the area of the AR is like 9x9. Mm-hmm. And I can definitely make the sculpture, like moving sculpture, wherever like I want. So I think it's...
Oh, so you're going to have actual, like, three-dimensional pieces interacting with you while you're in the virtual world?
Yes, because I want people to, like, when you get into the world, you touch it. Wait, like, am I real or he is real? Mm-hmm. Like, you have this, like, you don't really, you're not clear. I want that feeling. And you can talk, he will ask every single like viewer many like what sort of question, like deep but goofy. Sort of like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Deep but goofy. So would you need to build like an animatronic or something that moves?
Yeah, I want to do that, like, because one of my friends from grad school, she actually made those movable, like, what is that? Robot mm-hmm. in silicone. Like, it's really soft. But I think it's a really good start from what I'm visualizing it. So maybe I can start with the silicone, and inside is the robot part.
Yeah.
And outside I can build some like fur or like skin or whatever. I don't know.
Yeah, that'd be so crazy, because when I've done VR, I've, you know, when you touch things, like, you know, you're not really touching anything. Like, you'll have a controller and you'll sort of push the button.
Yeah.
Or sometimes you like crouch on the floor and like touch the floor, but like actually like physically feeling something.
Yeah.
Is a totally different.
Yeah, like design, like every single part, like whenever you can feel or you can sense, it's gonna be a long way to go though.
Oh yeah, that's a very elaborate.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, this was really insightful. I learned a lot of things today.
It's really good to talk to you.
Yeah, I love talking to you too. Is there anything else that you want to mention, or do you have any questions for me before we sign off?
Well, thank you again, and I like your lipstick. And and also earring. Yeah, and what else? Looking forward to the music video.
Yeah,
because I spent a long time on it.
No,
please,
no,
God.
Definitely. And we're really looking forward to finally showing Therapy Room.
Mm-hmm. Let me know. Yeah.
Yeah, we'll definitely let you know. So you say you regularly attend.
Yeah. But last 2 months I didn't have the chance. Yeah.
Oh, that's funny. Those were the first 2 months that I've been on.
Uh oh.
Yeah, I just started 2 months ago. So
yeah, I missed.
It's fine. I'll be here. This
yeah,
weekend.
I think May I will have the chance to go. Yeah.
Yeah, we're doing the Hungarian Cultural Festival
uh-huh.
showing.
Do you guys do the VR animation as well?
Yes. So most of our VR is we have like a VR virtual maiden lane, which is if you know you're interested in the architecture of the building,
mm-hmm.
and then certain exhibits they're not really games; they're more like interactive, like visual experiences.
Yeah.
It depends each month what we're doing.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. If it possible, I would love to like reach out to any VR animation like programmer. Like, if they're interested in doing it, I'm down.
Yeah, no, definitely. Well, I'll tell Devon that you want some more connections here in New York City about doing VR.
True, because wherever I get is just so far away from me.
Yeah, of course, Denmark is.
Denmark
is very far.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much. This was really nice. I look forward to seeing you at future events.
Yeah,
and
definitely.
I look forward to the rest of your projects in the future.
Yeah. Cool. Thank you.
Thank you.
If you would like to support this podcast and Animation Nights New York and help us keep our screening events free, consider making a donation to our PayPal, becoming our patron on Patreon where we offer perks, or just buying us a coffee. Every little bit helps. Please visit our website at animationnights.com. If you live in the greater New York City area, you can join us on the second Wednesday of every month at 180 Maiden Lane, located within the Seaport District of Manhattan, for our monthly screenings. We show animated short films and showcase virtual reality animation experiences from all around the world. Admission is free. Please keep supporting independent animation, and thank you so much for listening.
First of all, I actually... Oh.